Dakota first. Now, your local weather with the KX Storm Team.
That was not too bad for a mid-October afternoon. Fairly clear sky across western North Dakota, but it was cold this morning. If you walked outside, obviously, early in the day, you know that. Look at those temperatures. Now, 35 is actually on the hill in Minot, but pretty much everybody else was in the 20s. However, look at Medora, 19 degrees. Hettinger, only at 20. Williston, 21. Rugby 23, very, very cold night. So here's what you need to know for the next few days. You're going to want a jacket again early tomorrow morning because once again, the temperatures will be in the 20s. The temperatures will probably top out in the 50s tomorrow, and there's going to be a chance of rain Wednesday. Now, the better odds are going to be in the southern part of the state than the north. Right now in Bismarck, 57 degrees, winds out of the north-northwest at 12 miles an hour. In Minot, 53 degrees, northwest wind at 12 miles an hour. Williston, 56 degrees, winds out of the north at 9. And in Dickinson, 57, and we have a northeast breeze at 5 miles an hour in Dickinson. Here are some of the other temperatures around the area. Hettinger, 59 degrees. Again, that I mentioned it earlier. It was 60 in Hettinger just a little while ago, and pretty much from about Highway 83 to the east, the wind is a little bit stronger than what we're seeing here on the map in the west, roughly 5 miles an hour, maybe a little bit stronger than that at times in the west, but still not a real windy day. And I wanted to show you something here because it got really cold last night. It's going to get really cold again tomorrow morning. And a couple things going on. We're looking at the water vapor imagery, and this is moisture way up in the atmosphere. But what I'm really concerned with, not so much the moisture, that's where the purple is and the bright whites. I'm looking at the flow. So we have the wind on the ground out of the northwest. That's coming out of Canada. And way up in the atmosphere, the flow's out of Canada as well. So Mother Nature's really sending a Canadian air mass our way with nothing to stop it. The other thing, if you notice the darker colors heading towards North Dakota right now, that's drier air. So you have a clear sky, drier air. October, the temperature is going to fall. So again, tomorrow morning, we're probably looking at temps in the 20s to start the day. And there's that high pressure up in Saskatchewan right now, that flow around it. There's that Canadian air. A lot of rain down in Texas, but most of the eastern U.S., pretty decent weather right now. Now in our precision cast, here we are, 7 o'clock tonight, mostly a northerly flow of sorts. I don't see any clouds. There's certainly no rain. Now tomorrow, the wind is going to change direction. It's going to be out of the southeast tomorrow, maybe 10 miles an hour. Might be some spots with some stronger wind gusts, but not what we would consider a real windy day. By 12 noon, wind picks up a little bit. Again, 10, 15 miles an hour. By tomorrow evening, we start to see some clouds in the southern part of the state. Then on Wednesday, the south has a 20, 30% chance of rain on Wednesday, and the north, the odds are even less than that. Now, there is a potential for a little bit of fog up in the Turtle Mountains tonight. The only reason I point that out is while it may not be widespread with the temperatures in the 20s, if there is fog developing, well, that's a cloud on the ground. That's moisture. That moisture could freeze on the roads, making it pretty slick in the Turtle Mountains. Forecast temps tomorrow morning, 20s to start the day. So, yeah, you'll need the jacket. 40s by lunchtime, and tomorrow afternoon, 50s in the west, 40s in the east. And here's a look at the next 7 days. Really, these aren't real bad temperatures. Around 60 degrees for Minot on Thursday. Slight chance of rain for Minot in the north. But Lauren and Chad, for October, you know, those temperatures aren't that bad.
Not bad at all.
Not that bad. Thanks, Tom. Next.